method of training. So this is really about shaping our futures through conversations. The objective of today's session is shaping, learning how to shape our future together through conversations that matter. Insights of the founders is in their book, which is by Jonita Brown and David Isaacs, with the World Cafe Community of Practice, how through a training technology, we are able to capture conversations so that we can make the greatest meaning and meaningful decisions in which the voices of many different people are captured. So what is written about this World Cafe methodology is that it is new ways to make a difference in our lives and work. The power of conversation is so invisible and natural that we usually overlook it. If I were to ask you, what am I doing right now? What were we doing in the last 10 minutes? What were we doing? You can even use your chat box.
Ma'am, we were discussing on certain topic in that.
That we were having a conversation.
Informal kind of conversation. Not so formal things. We were just, you know, having some conversations which was not related to our topic kind of.
All right. And would that conversation shape your future?
Kind of.
Will it make a difference to your life?
Because it is like all the PPTs are, designed by you. So kind of it is going to help us with our exams and eventually with our careers as well.
Right. So a simple conversation, which we may think that, you know, what are we doing? But it has a power. It is invisible. And it has the power to shape your future. For example, consider all the learning and action choices that occur as people move from one conversation to another inside our organizations and communities. So if I were to think of an organization, what I would think is that normally when a decision is to be made, the top management might call a few important people or whomever they think are that this is an ideal person for making this for making this decision, and ultimately they would have a conversation with them. Now, what is important to note is that, of course, they are taking ideas through the conversation from these people. But is it that on that particular topic, they are the only ones who are having a conversation? No. There are several conversations which are happening across the organization on the same topic. And the ideas that are emerging in that conversation are not getting captured because in that formal setting, only those few people were called who were regarded as the great brains. And if you look at it, I keep saying this in our country, that is it that whatever is happening, that only the parties concerned, that they are the only ones who are discussing or having a conversation around it? No. Everyone who is related, unrelated, is discussing those larger or smaller issues. Now, organizations would stand to gain if they heard what the larger cross-section of the people would do. So, of course, methodologies like focus group discussion are used, particularly in marketing or in problem solving, where the people where the people concerned share more knowledge or more details or more things about that particular topic. However, what I liked about the World Cafe methodology is that it is not restrictive in nature. And on the same pertinent questions, the entire community can be involved in order to give their ideas. And that would make it the decision taken more holistic and inclusive by nature. What if we considered all the conversations as one dynamic cafe? That's what they write. Each a table in a larger network of living conversations, which is the core process for sharing our collective knowledge and shaping our future. Once we become aware of the power of conversation as a key process in all aspects of our lives, we can use it more effectively for our mutual benefit. So, what I have said so far is that conversations are important. Even when we think that conversations are not happening, conversations are happening. So, वैसे उसने मेरे से बात करना बंद कर दिया, उसने आपसे बात करना बंद कर दिया, उसने दूसरों से थोड़ी बात करना बंद किया. या आपने अपने आप से थोड़ी बात करना बंद किया. सो कॉन्वर्सेशंस हैपन एंड हाउ दे हैपन इज व्हाट इज इम्पोर्टेंट. आर दे हैपनिंग इन साइलोस और आर यू नेचुरली कैप्चरिंग द कॉन्वर्सेशंस अक्रॉस द प्रोसेस. आई ऑलवेज से
मैम जस्ट अ क्वेश्चन मैम, व्हाट इज साइलोस?
साइलोस इज स्मॉल ग्रुप्स.
ओके ओके.
Yeah, small, yeah. small groups. Okay. ये उसका ग्रुप है, ये इसका ग्रुप है. अच्छा, उसके ग्रुप ने ये किया है तो अब हमें तो इसका उल्टा ही करना है. So, I always say that in an organization, if you want to understand, get a feel of what is happening in the organization. जैसे पुराने जमाने में हम, आई डोंट नो आप पढ़ते थे या नहीं, लेकिन हम पढ़ते थे कि राजा को अगर ये पता करना है अबाउट द वेलफेयर ऑफ हिज प्रजा, वो अपना भेष बदल के और रात में निकल के जाता था और जहां लोग चारपाई बना के पांच छह लोग बैठे थे वहां पे उनको ज्वाइन करता था और वहां से वो खबर लेता था कि लोग क्या सोच रहे हैं. तो अगर आपको रियली आज के मॉडर्न डे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में पता करना है कि लोग आपके डिसीजन के बारे में क्या सोच रहे हैं, तो यू नीड टू गो टू द कैंटीन और द बैडमिंटन कोर्ट एंड सिट ओवर देयर एंड दैट्स हाउ यू विल कम टू गेट मोर आइडियाज. जो लोग इंक्लूडेड होते हैं वो पावरफुल फील करते हैं, जो एक्सक्लूडेड होते हैं वो कॉन्वर्सेशन तो करते ही हैं इवन इफ दे फील मार्जिनलाइज्ड. So why not capture their process? So once we become aware of the power of conversation as a key process in all aspects of our lives, we can use it more effectively for our mutual benefit. So today,
Sometimes we can also use grapevine for this kind of purpose. I mean, it can be used sometimes in a positive way as well. Grapevine. I mean, informal, to get an idea about what informal conversations are going on in the organizations.
No, the whole conversation is around using it in a positive way. That's the point I'm making. You see, I'll share a very recent experience of mine with you. I am on the committee of another organization, and in that organization, I was nominated along with three other people It's a very interesting example for me. I was nominated along with another three people. And these three people and four of us, the task was ki should the governing body and the execution body be the same? Because right now the role of the board plays the role of both policy making as well as execution. It's a non-profit organization. So the four of us discussed and decided, and we agreed that we need to take the views of more professional members. We need to capture their ideas. And we designed four questions, and we said that around these four questions, let us capture their ideas through a survey. So what happened was that, of course, we did get ideas. If there were 200 people, at least 70 of them did give their ideas. And then we summarized all those ideas. But parallelly, what started happening was, by mistake, the current president, instead of only sending it to the ex-role holders, she sent the questionnaire to the entire professional membership, those who were not role holders in the past also. And all these people, they started coming up with all kinds of negativity, according to me. It was so negative that how come these people have been chosen? Why not these people? These were the people who are this thing. But it was so crude, that entire process, to the extent that, as far as I was concerned, it was a huge learning and inner transformation, I would say to you very honestly. And that I thought, is it worth? Matlab, what is it? But when the four of us got together, we had a conversation, and we could turn around the whole negativity into a positive thing. We said, okay, these were the stalwarts. These are the people who have done a lot of work in institution building. Although the suggestion has come in a very demeaning and negative way, yet it is a suggestion. So why not we distribute amongst ourselves and decide to talk to these stalwarts one-on-one. And let us also hold a Zoom meeting and do a focus group with the rest of the role holders whose written communication has not come. And we had the first of those meetings yesterday. So, you know, whether a conversation is negative, Bhumi, to answer your question, even if it is negative, I learned through this experience that there is a possibility of going beyond what is being overtly said, acknowledging the jealousy, the negativity amongst people, and yet using it in a positive way. So we had the first of the meetings yesterday for about 3 to 4 hours. And it was very good, because we got some very good ideas on whether the board should separate governance and execution ideas. We also got the feelings of the group, that why they don't want to share and things like that. So a conversation can always, even if it is in a negative spirit by other people, depending on the way that we respond to it, we can always turn it into a positive conversation.
Yes, and ma'am, actually, that is the whole point that I was about to say, and you explained it so nicely, that, you know, grapevine is one of the situations which is through which we get to know about the negative areas and can use it to the organization's benefit. It's one of the part of communication, right? But definitely informal communication going on in the organization, but it, you know, a person, for example, a leader, an HR, can use it to the organization's benefit. Even if it is negative, that is actually in the benefit of the organization if taken in certain, I mean, you know, utilized in a way, kind of.
So it requires a very high level of transcendence to come out of your own feelings of hurt and negativity and yet take the positive, take a very positive view of what is happening. So now coming back to World Cafe, this is large group discussions. However, this large group discussion is broken down into small groups of 4 to 5 people each. The key topic is selected, discussions are held, and the people are divided into 4, depending on the size of the group. They are divided, like for instance, this is 33. So 3 of us, maybe Arun, me, and maybe another person from ISTD, so 30 of you. So if I have to make groups of 5, right? So like that, there would be 5 topics and you would have 20 minutes to discuss and in a particular topic at a particular table. So the first round I will assign you, and then after that, in the second round, you would go to another table, and whatever question has been assigned to that table, you will give your ideas. Every table will have a table host, that is a leader who, after that group disperses, will remain as the host of the table. And the new people who come into that group, the host is going to explain the key points of what were discussed and take new ideas from the new people who have come. So in this way, this goes on in 3 rounds. So you can imagine like you have gone to a big marriage party and there are different tables over there. And it's not that if you by and large know the population, you get stuck at one table, you spend some time, talk to some people, then go to another table, talk to other people, go to another table. So although it is called World Cafe method, I don't know whether in a cafe, a person would really move from table to table. But definitely in a marriage setting where you know a lot of people, or at a party setting where you know a lot of people, this is what you're likely to do. In this training technology, this is what is recommended and what is done. And I think that it is very creative way of capturing the ideas of all the people. After these 3 rounds are over, then the host at each table who has stayed back is going to tell the other people, come back to the larger group and tell all the other people that on this topic, these were the ideas which were discussed and this is what we have come to. Isko kehte hai harvesting of ideas in the terms of the authors. So the host will brief everybody about the key points and then come back to the larger group and share it. Now, how do you record the ideas? You can simultaneously prepare a PPT, you can do a video recording of the discussions, you can write notes and you can come and share the notes. I leave the methodology to the group in terms of how you're going to do. While you're sitting at the table, of course, this is not physical, this is a virtual table, but you know, it's like a table mat is put, a paper table mat is put, and in front of each person. And even now, when you go to some restaurants, there are table mats and people can doodle their ideas, they can draw their ideas, they can write adjectives about their ideas, and then leave them over there and move on to the next table. Now, what is the role of the host? The host is the leader. He's a participant, but he is not the controller. He cannot play an authoritarian role. He has to only be like a facilitator who spurs the group when there is silence, keeps the energy level going, and jot down the ideas. So he should not over facilitate, as in he's the only person who is talking, and he should make sure that everyone who is silent, who needs to be encouraged, who needs to be told, okay, let's listen to another person. So he has to make sure that all the ideas are captured. Now, this is one set of questions that I'm going to give you. And then we are going to divide ourselves into six groups, six or five people each. Now, before we do that, I just want to tell you a couple of things. That only questions that matter in service to real work are asked. Cafes in different contexts can be named differently. Like people can be meeting, it can be called a strategy cafe or a leadership cafe, a community cafe, a creative cafe. And World Cafe conversations are based on the principles and format developed by the World Cafe, a global movement to support conversations that matter in corporate, government, and community settings around the world. So pay attention to the reason you're bringing people together and what you want to achieve. Know the purpose and parameter of your meeting. And for example, who should be part of the conversation? What themes? I think to me, what theme you should discuss is very important. Because then the harvest that you have is what is going to be important. So first thing is that create a hospitable space. Make people feel comfortable and make people feel comfortable enough to open up to each other. Explore questions that matter. Encourage everyone's contribution. Connect diverse perspectives. Listen together for patterns and insights and share collective discoveries. So powerful questions should be asked, which are simple and clear and thought-provoking, generate energy, focuses inquiry, surfaces unconscious assumptions, and opens new possibilities. So in this is cafe session that we are going to have, what you are going to do is you are going to discuss around culture in classrooms. So culture, as you know, is a word for the way of life of groups of people, meaning that the way they do things. Excellence of taste in fine arts and humanities is also known as high culture. It's an integrated part of human knowledge, belief, and behavior. The outlook, attitudes, values, morals, goals, and customs shared by a society. The term school culture generally refers to the beliefs, perceptions, relationships, attitudes, and written and unwritten rules that shape and influence every aspect of how a school functions. But the term also encompasses more concrete issues such as physical and emotional safety of students, orderliness, etc. Now, I've taken a definition, given definition, a standard given definition. That's why I should actually be putting this in inverted commas. I have not added anything of my own. But because you are in the context of training, that is why I want to pick up culture and make 6 questions in the context of training. So when I make group 1, what is group 1 going to discuss? You are going to discuss the hallmarks of a toxic culture in a classroom. What are the enablers of toxic culture and what are the blockers of creating a toxic culture in a classroom? So after I make the groups, I will also do a broadcast of this. I will write it and send it, because right now you don't know which group you belong to. But I'm telling you what you are going to do. So group 2 will discuss, in your experience, what are the different cultures you have experienced in classrooms. Make a model of the different cultures that you have experienced. And group 3 will discuss that what should be the facilitator behaviors which block. And so these are 3 groups. Group 1, group 2, group next round. As I told you, we are going to do only 2 rounds. In the next round, all of you will be sent to different tables where you can contribute your ideas in round 2. Group 4 is going to share the changing landscape of business scenario and implications of adult learning. And group different differences in learning styles of multi-generational workforce. And group 6 is going to share trainers' role and perspectives and the development that a trainer needs to go through in the current scenario. So these are the 6 questions that we will explore. We will not discuss it for 20 minutes because it's already going to be 2:45. We'll discuss it for 15 minutes and then I will change your tables. Each one of you will be sent to a different table. You will choose a host right at the beginning. That one host will continue to remain, and the remaining 4 people I will shift to different tables. So if you have any questions, you can ask me at this stage.
Ma'am.
Someone has been so good that they have already written it in the chat box. Thank you so much. I really appreciate this. Isko kehte hai Priyanka facilitation. Wonderful. So great.
One of the hosts is decided already.
Huh?
One of the hosts is already decided. She's so quick with all this facilitation.
I'm really grateful for this, but it saves me a lot of trouble. Now I'm dividing you very naturally into 6 groups. You are going to get this, and after 15 minutes, remember, by 3:00, I would have shifted you to different groups. So kindly join your groups. Yeah, so Pratiksha Patil, Rohit Sharma, Durga, Rajnikant, Nivedita, where are you? Are you there or not there? Nivedita, Saurabh, Rajnikant, Pratiksha, Durga, Rohit, Pavan. मम्मी थोड़ा दरवाजा बंद कर लीजिए आप।
Rekha ma'am, can I get assigned to a breakout? I got out of the Zoom meeting because of some technical snags. So if you could do that, please. I cannot hear you, ma'am. You're on mute.
Who is speaking to me?
Avirul, ma'am. It's Avirul.
Huh?
Avirul, ma'am. Avirul Kota.
Avirul, which group were you in, Avirul?
Ma'am, I got out of the Zoom meeting before the breakout room happened because of some snacks. So, can you assign me to one?
No, I will. In the next round, I'll assign.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, my internet got, I don't know what happened to it. I just came out of the room. Could you put me again in the room?
Who is this?
This is Sakshi. I was in room 5.
Okay, Sakshi, I've closed the rooms now. I'll send you to a different room. Okay, so welcome back. All of you are here. I can see that. Can you tell me who was the leader of group 1?
Ma'am, Prateek.
Ma'am, I am the leader for the group 1.
Who is this?
Prateek, ma'am.
Prateek. Okay. And group 2?
Arpita.
Arpita, yeah.
Yeah, and group 3?
Suma.
Huh?
Suma.
Suma.
Yes, ma'am.
Suman Lata is written here.
Yes, ma'am, correct.
Suma Lata.
Yes, ma'am.
And group 4 did not exist because none of the participants joined. So group 5?
Sakshi.
Sakshi.
Ashok Panda, Ashok Panda.
And group 6? Group 6, who was the leader?
Ma'am, Mr. Ashok Panda.
No.
Mr. Ashok Panda. All right. So what I'm going to do now is I'm assigning you to different groups. You will be going to different groups other than the leaders will be there. And so you please join in.
Ma'am, the host remains the same, right?
Yeah, Prateek ke alawa sare jo tum log ho, different groups mein jaoge.
Ma'am, everyone has joined the group?
Yeah, please join. I am assigning you.
I have not joined any
group. But I am assigning you one by one.
Okay, ma'am. All right.
Have you all joined?
Ma'am, I have not been assigned.
No, no, ma'am.
Even I haven't joined any of the groups.
Ma'am, I have not assigned any of the groups.
You see that window that notification.
Okay, now, okay. Now I have gotten an option.
Anybody who is here and who has not joined? Aviral, are you there? Okay, so I can see that all of you are back. Welcome back. And now I would request the leader of group one, Mr. Prateek.
Yes, ma'am.
So you'll have about 3-4 minutes, okay. Not more than that. And in that, to kindly share all the ideas that were shared in your group with respect to the first question, what are the hallmarks of a toxic culture, classroom right. culture, and what are its enablers and what are its blockers?
Right. So ma'am, the hallmark of toxic classroom culture we discussed.
I need to see your face first of all, Prateek.
Okay, I'll try.
Yeah, at least while you're talking, I need to see your faces.
Hello, ma'am.
So first of all, tell me, what was the experience? How did the people who were in group one feel? How are you feeling? Sad, bad, mad, glad?
So it was it was glad.
Yeah, you are saying on behalf of the group, or it happened so?
No, it happened so. So it was glad and mad, I could say.
Glad and mad also.
Mad as in crazy mad, not the other way around.
It was good, right. Ma'am. It was good to meet Prateek, Bhumi and Pooja in the breakout room, and we had a good discussion.
Mm-hmm. Please share the main points.
Right. So under hallmarks, we discussed the few pointers were when there is no communication among team members. These are the hallmark of toxic culture. When there is importance given to grapevine rather than facts.
Yeah, you go on.
And then not ready to listen to each other. So these are the certain hallmarks for toxic classroom culture. Then under enablers, the pointers that we discussed were when people have their own personal motives rather than group goals, when there is a lot of formality, when there is lack of motivation, when there is strict hierarchy when people follow, when there is lack of clarity about goals, and another one, when there is groupism based on culture, race, ethnicity, and other social factors. So okay. These are the enablers. Under the blockers, we discussed when we promote teamwork, these are the blockers. When there is freedom to express opinion. The other one was thinking of we before I. And then aligning goal with those of the group. When you have a group aligned with other team members, that can lead up to the blockers. When you celebrate small achievements. And the last one was when you have a collaborative leadership. So these were the points that we discussed.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
In the PPT.
Sure.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
So is there anything anyone wants to add? Otherwise, we can give him a big round of applause.
Yes, you ma'am.
Like Prateek, a big round of applause, but I'd also like to add that a proper conflict resolution is very, very important to prevent toxic cultures, because interpersonal conflicts can quickly lead to a very toxic culture. And if they're not properly handled, it can be, I don't know, an enabler or a blocker. I don't know which one it is.
It is conflict management.
Yeah, that's a great idea for the blocker. Thank you.
Conflict management. Yeah.
Conflict management. Perfect. Thank you so much.
Great, wonderful.
Thank you, ma'am.
We go to group two and Arpita is there. Let's hear Arpita. Where is Arpita?
Yes, ma'am.
Hi, Arpita, your camera, please.
Yeah, sure. Ma'am, the topic for us was classrooms to make a model for it.
Hmm.
So the different cultures out of it would take it. Right. So people who, you know, I have some internet issues. Maybe that's the reason.
Okay, then do you think it will help if you put on your camera?
Maybe, let me try.
Ah.
Okay, can you hear me now properly? Yeah.
With a lag, but yes, definitely.
Am I audible?
So how was the atmosphere in your cafe?
All right. Breaking stereotypes first. Okay, it was very interactive. Like we three were discussing. First of all, we were in a little dilemma as to what really to put down. But once we came about with it, so the ideas were flowing thick and fast. So it was good. It was good. It was nice interactive session.
Go ahead, Arpita. Please share.
So
just share the model.
The model, I'm going to take a picture and share it with you, but I'll briefly tell you that.
Can you share screen?
Yeah, the first pointer. I will. Yeah, probably. No, it says only the host can share this in the meeting.
Let me see.
So,
I'm making you co-host. Now see if you can share screen.
And now share the screen.
I made you co-host. Yeah.
Yeah. Can you see it?
Yeah.
But I can't see anything in my screen. I wonder what am I broadcasting?
I don't know. It says everything on your screen, including notifications, will be recorded.
Okay. I'll just take a photo of it and share it with you guys because I'm not very conversant with this. Hello?
Yeah, you see. Arpita,
are you?
Arpita? Yeah, tell me.
Okay, yes.
Yeah.
You may even share it with one of your teammates or somebody who was in your group who can share it via laptop or in a computer.
Yeah. Actually, Amreen, are you there? You had made the chat. Would you like to share it so that I can think about it then?
I am on phone. If I'll just try if I can share. Give me a second. Let me see.
I minimize meeting. It will minimize the meeting and open the homepage of the phone for you, and then you can go to that drawing.
Arpita, can you stop sharing the screen? Maybe then I can share it.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, go on, do it. Have you got it now? Yeah.
Can you see?
Yes.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
You can explain
it then. All right. So the different cultures in the classroom. Is it clear?
Yeah, it's better now.
Okay. So the first offshoot or the point was breaking stereotypes, considering that people from different cultures are there or their presence is there in the classroom, we were talking of breaking stereotypes, that is, you know, considering that they come from different social, economic, and learning backgrounds, because this is a classroom scenario that we're talking about. People who are very experienced, then some of them are students, some of them have no idea about training and development. So we have to keep those differences in mind for a good culture to be cultivated in the classroom. The second bit is learning styles. People learn differently. Their pace of learning is different. They could have different questions. Something that may seem very easy to one may not. Others may have difficulty in grasping it. So absorb and keep that in mind as well. The last point was difficult, inactive, or non-participative students. They also candidates. They also have to be kept in mind, and discouraging incivilities. So people who don't want to be, who are there for whatever reason, they are difficult or inactive. They don't really actively participate in the classrooms. They are closed-minded and may not be very open about people from different cultures, different backgrounds. We have to nip them in the bud. So that was one of the points that came out of this as well. So yeah, this is what we discussed.
Very nice. Yeah, this is a model. You kept your participant at the center.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. I hope the others agree. I have Ranjita and Amreen. Anything to add?
Yes, perfectly.
Perfect. All right.
Yeah, perfectly. Perfect, yeah.
Okay. So you can stop sharing and then we go to group three, Suman. Suma, you were put into group one, so you only have the points of round one. So yes, would you ma'am. Like to share the points of round one?
Sure.
You'll have to share with them again the topic that you discussed.
Sure, ma'am. Let me share my screen.
Facilitator behaviors.
Yes.
Ma'am, she was also in round group five.
I know that.
Yes. So this is what we've discussed, ma'am. What should be the facilitator behaviors that enable growth? So these are the points that we had discussed. Is facilitator should be open to new ideas, should encourage learning, and should be neutral to all the participants, not be biased with anyone, and then be an active listener, able to understand the verbal and non-verbal communication, and also should be able to demonstrate the right verbal and non-verbal communication. Involve the learners and know your audience well by using different techniques like questioning skills, use icebreakers to understand your audience well. So we discussed about audience management. And then we discussed about the right skill set that a facilitator should possess, a polite and friendly attitude, and also should be knowledgeable to demonstrate the skills that the facilitator has. Also, we discussed about gathering information, different perspectives from the audience, do a knowledge check, knowledge gain to gauge the participant's understanding levels. Then facilitation is also about providing the required content or material, be it the e-learning or any assignments or any other courses that the facilitator can suggest the participants. Then we talked about simulate learning by doing role plays or doing activities, giving assignments, and should work towards inclusive growth. We spoke about the ILT, the classroom method, and the virtual scenario. How would you be prepared, the readiness from the instructor? How would you make them comfortable in the virtual scenario by giving them instructions, right instructions to enable them to interact well? So these are the points that we had discussed in the group one.
Thank you. Very nice. Anyone would like to add anything to this?
I guess no other inputs.
So wonderful. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you, Suma. This was wonderful. Beautiful, in fact.
Thank you so much.
We move on to group five, Sakshi.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Sakshi.
Okay. So, ma'am, so our topic was differences in learning styles of multi-generational workforce.
Yeah.
And so in both the groups, we were able to discuss it. In the first group, there was half of discussion, and in the second, we completed it. So we have divided this on three levels. One is the youngsters. Youngsters, those are on the lower level, executive level of position in the workplace. The second level is the middle age, that is the middle level management. And the third is the experienced age, that is on the leadership level position people. So according to the group discussion, we were able to define that the learning style of youngsters were through mostly through auditory, video, and the kinesthetic way of learning. And for the middle age group, the most important part of learning is through interpersonal and intrapersonal communication, as well as through linguistics and little of video and audio. And for the third and the most, I would say, experienced group, intrapersonal and interpersonal is the one where they feel important as a learning aspect. Along with it, their individual auditory and video experiences, like they involve themselves in reading, they involve themselves in watching videos of some influenced people, like that. So the major area of their learning is through those three ways. That is it we have discussed. I welcome the other participants if anything has been left there.
Ma'am?
Yeah.
We considered, initially the Neil Flaming's model instead of David Kohl's model. Hello?
Sorry, yes.
Okay. We considered this initially the Neil Flaming's WART model for learning styles when I was in the group 5. And then later on, we were about to discuss, but maybe because it was like a little, discussion went on a little long. So we were not able to discuss about the David Kohl's method, but we considered Neil Fleming's WART model.
Very nice. Thank you. You're sharing the process of what you discuss.
Yes.
Thank you, Bhumi, and thank you, Sakshi. Pandaji.
Yeah,
yours was the last question, no?
Absolutely. Well, the topic that was given to us was trainee's role, perspectives and developments. And along with me was Priyanka, Manali and Amreen. Well, here are a couple of the points which I thought I should across. The first thing, discussed was, there's a lot of change, Earlier, there was sort of an authority. Somebody is a teacher, somebody is a trainer. That authority thing is gone. It has been converted to more of sharing of learning. That's a very vital point, which is. And it has become more participative in nature, And the other thing which we discussed was, there's no much of a strict rules and regulations which we strictly adhere to. The facilitator is a very friendly person who sees the end results, rather than being strict in the class. A lot of emphasis has been given to creativity and innovations. And another one thing, in training and particularly the employees, which was focused was more than how much money you get, how you feel is more important, That is a very important point, which we thought. Then, as I told you, sharing of wisdom and a facilitator doesn't behave like a teacher. There's a lot of, self-connection also when we, and there's a lot of self-connectivity. And if anything, you know, negative happens, we always try to move towards the positivity. So, you know, that is a very important thing. And a lot of, you know, new technologies and practical and scientific sharing is there. And earlier, you know, there was no much of a simulation or gamification done. But these days, you know, there's a lot of gamification is being done. And other than that, a very important vital point which I wanted to put it across is there is intermingling of culture. It means, you know, globalization is have come to the fore. You know, what is happening in Japan or London or US, you know, we are trying to also, if it is good to us, we try to discuss about that. Earlier, it was more, you know, circumscribed to particular norms. And we have gone beyond the norms. And we are discussing something new and beyond board. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And thank you to all the six groups. Rather, there were five groups which discussed. I took you around the experience of a World Cafe method training technology in two cycles, although in reality there are three cycles which are done, keeping in mind the time. This is the methodology that we adopted. Yes, Bhumi, you seem to have a question. But before you ask your question, I want to ask you a question that through experiencing, are you clear about the methodology and the text which I shared in the beginning before starting the session?
Yes, ma'am. And I mean, it is quite clear now that what the whole idea of World Cafe is and how we can utilize it as one of our training, experiential training methodologies.
Okay. Yes, Bhumi, please go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. So now I have, you know, while there is one question on this models also in the assignment section. So while doing all the research on it, and reading through a lot of articles and, you know, a lot of things, I came across one of the questions which I wanted to ask. And thankfully, I was today put in this group wherein we were discussing learning styles.
Where you were discussing?
Learning styles. Learning styles, okay. So now I want to ask you that since we have discussed largely about David Cobb's experiential learning model,
yes,
which incorporates learning styles, different learning styles. But I am a little, skeptical about whether we are using Howard Gardner's multiple intelligences, which also includes interpersonal and interpersonal intelligence as one of the things that need to be considered while deciding upon training methodology. Are we considering Howard Gardner's model? Because in education industry, educational domain, we do highly use it, Howard Gardner's model. But I am not very sure whether L&D, learning and development domain in the corporate culture uses it or not. I mean, Howard Gardner's model.
Actually, it depends on the organization, the culture. The culture of training in the organization, the kind of need of the organization. So different organizations and different trainers, they are trained in different styles. They have their own preference style. So it will be difficult to make a general answer to such a specific question.
Ma'am, the only reason I asked is, sorry to interrupt, the only reason I asked is because it is much debated in the learning and development domain. I have seen it is much debated model. It is very highly used in education domain, which I belong to as a trainer. But I don't know about the corporate domain of learning and development, whether it is used or not. So I just want to know whether it is still used or not used, so that if a question pertaining to such a thing comes up, we can or we may include it. to put our point forth or something.
So I have not done any research study on this Bhumi.
Okay.
So I don't want to make a conclusive answer, nor have I come across any study so far. But by the time I come back for your next class, let me look through and see if there is any study on whether Howard Gardner's model of learning is used in the corporate culture. I can promise you that.
Okay, and it is the model of multiple intelligence. It is widely known as the model of multiple intelligence, which is then used to devise training methodologies in the educational domain in the classroom culture.
Yeah. Okay. I'm aware of the model. But yes. Whether it is used extensively in corporate or not, I have no data to comment on that.
Okay.
So I don't want to make a comment without doing some research myself on.
Okay, ma'am. No, not an issue, but thank you very much. And, you know, if you want, even I can write to you about it in case. So that just as a reminder, because this is something that that has been, you know, in my mind, like I would be asking ma'am. And luckily I got that question and got reminded of that.
All right, fine.
Thank you.
My paper is experiential learning. So that is why the focus in my sessions has been on the different experiential learning methods. Yeah, Bhumi, I hope that answers your question.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So, yes, Priyanka, you want to say something?
I want to get some recommendations specifically from you about books that we can read for deepening our knowledge of experiential learning. I find these classes so fascinating, and it's not something we come across a lot, like this World Cafe and what we did last class also. It was really fascinating. Is there some book where we have a list of everything together, like all the methodologies?
Yeah, so what I will do is that next time when I come, I will come with a bibliography, because that will be my last class. So I'll put together that whatever I have discussed with you, that what can be the readings, the articles on that. That can be one of the things that I will share with you. Okay. Fine. So we call it a day, and we are already 15 minutes over time. Thank you for your participation, and I hope you really enjoyed your discussion, conversations. You could find value in it. And let's meet again in high spirits next Saturday for the last time. Bye-bye to everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Thank you. So today's day was stolen by the girls, is it?